Hey, so Miran, today we are going to talk about gimbals and how to use gimbals in weddings. So gimbals are not new, they have taken all over the internet for past 1 year and there have been a lot of gimbals now. But the two best gimbals which I always recommend to everyone is the Moza Air and the Zhiyun Crane. I personally use this Zhiyun Crane version 1, it's not the 2 or the version 2 or the plus, it's just the Zhiyun Crane version 1. And absolutely I do not have any reasons to upgrade because this does like everything for me. So I remember I have been using my Undline or the Steadicam for like past 5 or 6 years and man, it's so complex to get the shots right, really takes a lot of time. But once I got this gimbal, I mean I haven't looked back. I have just thrown all of my old gimbals and Steadicams, they're just lying or snoring somewhere in my warehouse. Anyways, so with the onset of those pistol size electronic motors, it just makes the job so easy for everyone to get the shots right, get the shots look like high production movies. It's really amazing. So in this video I'm gonna explain you few things you need to keep in mind if you're using a gimbal in weddings. So let's get to it one by one. So point one, always shoot at higher frame rate. It's like 60 fps or even 120 fps depending on the shot you are looking to achieve. I recommend shooting at high frame rate because you can slow it down in the pose so that you can get rid of any of the micro jitter or micro any kind of shake or micro jitter, anything. You can just get rid of all of it while you slow down the footage in your pose. So always shoot at higher frame rates. Point two, get the shots at Dutch angle. Dutch angle is one of the shots which is always used in high production movies. Bollywood, Hollywood, you see it everywhere. So what I mean with Dutch angle is you have to like go in and out moving the camera all the way to the left, all the way to the right, something like this, and going in then going out all the way. So here is an example so you can understand what I mean with it. Manual focusing. Do not depend on the autofocus on any of your cameras because you are moving, your subject is moving, the distance is changing and the camera is always going to hunt with the focus and you absolutely do not want to see that in your footages. What I always recommend is set your camera to the manual focus, use the focus peaking if your camera supports. Sony and Panasonic absolutely supports that. Canon and Nikon do not have focus peaking, so forget about it. But if you are on a Sony or Panasonic, use focus peaking, use manual focus. You can see what's there in the focus with your focus peaking. Absolutely amazing. Just maintain the correct distance and you can have the perfect proper gimbal shots. Point four, ninja walking. It's like, I cannot show that to you right now, but it's about just walk with your toes slowly and try to not have any kind of micro jitter or shake to your footage or the gimbal. You need to absorb the tension in your hands. Use both the hands and just walk slowly with your toes. That's called ninja walking. You can check about it on the internet. There are a lot of videos about it. I'm not going to explain a lot about it. Point five, only plan slow shots. Do not plan like some heavy. I have seen a lot of people going crazy with their gimbals. Absolutely not recommended because you can shoot anything you want because those footage are not going to get, or it will not be any usable for any kind of timeline. So absolutely doesn't make sense. Just try for slow moments, let it tell a story. Slow moments, you can then again slow it down if you are shooting at higher frame rates and it's going to look amazing. Point six, plan your shots. I absolutely always recommend planning your shots, whether it's a gimbal, whether it's a camera, whether it's a drone, whether it's GoPro. Always, always, always plan your shots. Whatever you are going to really use it in your timeline, plan your shots, get the shots. It absolutely doesn't make sense getting hundreds of shots and then not able to use even one of it because everything looks, either it looks too fast or too slow or too jittery or like tack, 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 tack. Not going to happen, you're not going to use it anyways. Point seven, always use both the hands while getting your shots because if you are using just one hand, you will not be able to compensate with the micro jitter and the micro shakes. Not going to happen. You need to use both the hands. Use both the hands. Start walking with it. Start getting the shots. You will be having absolutely amazing shake-free footage right then. Point eight, do not overuse it. Do not just get all the shots in a gimbal. Absolutely doesn't make sense keeping all the moving shots, tick, 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 tick. All those moving shots all through the timeline. You need to have both like static shots, you need to have gimbal shots. So just plan about it, do not just overuse it. Point 9, you can also use your gimbal as a zip. You absolutely do not need a huge zimmy zip for your wedding. You can just have your gimbal and get one of your tallest tripods, put the tripod ring in over there in the gimbal, and then just point your gimbal all the way to the shot. And you can do a lot of it. I cannot show it to you right now. Maybe in the next wedding, I will show you all the examples like behind the scenes. This time we had a lot of shots, but I did not shoot the behind the scenes. Maybe next time. 10th point, your gimbal is having a lot of modes. Do not just use one mode all throughout the wedding. Like I have seen people using just this or just this or just this or just this. There are a lot of modes. You can go in or out, out to in, side to side, then up to down, Dutch angle, lot of things you can do with the gimbals. I'm going to do a detailed video about a lot of modes one gimbal can do, but that will be altogether a separate video. So those are the best 10 points you can really use to get your wedding gimbal game all the way to a next level. So that's pretty much all about the things you need to keep in mind while using the gimbal in weddings. If you have got any questions, just let me know in the comment section below. Smash the subscribe button if you haven't done it yet. And don't forget to click on the bell icon to stay updated. I will see you next time.